So you might be wondering, if you don't have a phone, what you can do. Well, Android Studio has actually provided a way for you to simulate a phone on your computer. This simulated phone has a fancy name called the Android Emulator. To start the Android Emulator, go ahead and go up to the Run button and press Run. You'll see a small loading circle down here. Now, whereas before I'd told you to select the Choose a Running Device radio button, you're going to want to choose the Launch Emulator radio button. And here is a drop-down of all the different types of phones you can simulate. Right now, you should only have one, and it's most likely going to be a Nexus 5, which is the type of phone. An API 21 refers to the operating system level. An x86 refers to a particular type of hardware configuration. Anyways, this is the name for your simulated phone, and I'm going to go ahead and click OK to start the phone. Now, after about 10 seconds, you should see a black phone appear on the screen. You'll also see this window here appear, which will show any sort of error messages or activity messages from the phone. Okay, so here's my black phone, and I'm waiting for it to load. And after a moment of that, I'm going to see this Android loading icon. And after a little bit more time, you should see this welcome screen appear on the phone. To go ahead and start the phone, swipe up from the bottom. Now it's trying to simulate an actual phone, and the first time you load up an actual phone, you get all these help icons and dialogues. I'm going to just click OK. Now if all goes well, your app should appear on your phone. It didn't for me, so I'm going to go ahead and try to run it again. Okay, since the emulator is already running, I can see it now under my Choose Running Device. So I'll go ahead and click it, and I'll press the OK button. Alright, and it loaded up my code on my emulated phone. Now I should note that sometimes these simulated phones don't always work correctly the first time. For example, you might have this issue that I had the first time when I ran my simulated phone, where it would just show the black screen or it would just show the Android loading symbol, and it wouldn't go beyond that. These are actually fairly common errors when trying to start a simulated phone, and one of the reasons that we suggest using a real device. That said, for the most part, they're solvable problems. So if you are running into those issues, go ahead and look at the instructor notes for how to deal with these situations. We've provided a link to a troubleshooting document. Finally, since I have your attention, if you're having difficulty with your simulated phone, sometimes you have clues in this error output over here.